In the first public interview on television that Phyllis Schlafly gave, she was wearing just like a very simple blue knitted sweater. In the next one, she was wearing an outstanding orange dress. Then Bella Abzug always was with hats. There was also a reason. All the men had to take their hat off inside. She never did. That was a statement. It is like, we women are here. You can't take us away. You can't overview us any longer. We are here. And I think that is just an amazing message. So Miss America is a very important project for me because it talks about the equal rights for women. It was for me very empowering to learn about all these iconic women that then later on I had to dress and to make the costumes for. I think through the costumes, the actors often can get a guideline to find their deeper inner aspects of their characters. And I think you can see that very clearly in the costume design of Miss America. There's a strict line between the antis and the pros at the beginning of the series, just based on the colors I used, the textures, and also the shapes. So the antis, they were wearing more A-line skirts. I avoided any kind of pants. And the pros, they were all wearing much louder patterns, louder colors. They were mostly pants. Their clothes were much more empowering themselves than the conservative shapes of the 70s conservative American housewives. I find that very interesting, how women in public use their wardrobe to stand out and also to stand out in a man's world. For that, it was for me so important to make all the characters very approachable so that we can identify with them, but that they really look real and that my costumes don't take too much attention from what they have to say. It is not a period television show about something in our past, because we are still fighting for equal rights. I want that the audience looks into their eyes and listens to them and that they think, oh my God, this is an amazing woman. If she can do it, I also can do it.